Today, I'm going to teach you about frequency function. We have this data set here. You can see we have some people and their age. So to understand frequency function, let's actually just first talk about count if function. So basically conditional counting. So here we have all of these different people. So let's say we want to know how many people in this list are 24 years old. So if I had 24 here, I could do equals count if, open parentheses, and then if I select this range, comma, and then I can say 24. So as you can see, I get a 3 because, well, if we go through this list, there's 1 here, 2 here, and 3 here. Now, something we might want to do is to group them in different brackets and say, okay, let's see how many people we have that are between, let's say, 0 and 24 years old, right? So basically that would include 23, 22, 23, all of those. So something like that we could do by doing this. We could check, let me not link to this cell just to keep this simple. I'm gonna check if it's less than or equal to 24. And as you can see, I got 8. So again, if we go through the list, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. So frequency function is going to do something similar to this. So what we can do, we can basically categorize what we call classes and then count how many occurrences of a number we have within a class. So let's do an example of that. Let's just keep this one as is right here. We know that here I did less than or equal to 24. So up to 24 years old. So let's say I want to get some counts. I want to get some counts for people between 0 and 24, and then between 25 to 30. And then finally 36 and up. So how can we do this? Basically what we need to do, we need to set the upper limit for this. So for example, in this first group, we have 0 to 24. 24 is the upper limit. I'm gonna do 24. And then for the next one, I'm gonna do 30. And then for this one, I'm gonna do 35. And then for this one, there is really no upper limit. So I'm gonna skip that one. So now what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go here and do frequency function. And here we have two arguments. The first one is data, which is gonna be this range of numbers, comma. And then we have what we call classes, which is gonna be these upper limits right here. If I close parentheses and hit enter, see we got 8, 2, 3, 2. So this 8 is gonna be 0 to 24, so 24 included, and that would be this number. Then the next one is gonna be after 24, so for example, if you had 24.1, that would go in this next class. Now for our numbers, we just have whole numbers, so we'll just say 25, but remember that technically this is anything that's above 24. So now we go from 25 up to this number included. So if we check how many we have between 25 and 30, we'll get, well, these don't count. This is 1, that's 25. We have this 30, which is 2. 30 is included, and that's it. So we got 2 of those. As you can see, that's exactly what we have here. And finally, we have 3 for this category, which is gonna be after 30 up to 35. So again, if we count through this, you'll see we have 3 of those. And then finally, for anything that's above 35, in this case, it's gonna be 36 and up, we have 2. So if we check here, see we have 1, and we have 2, and that's it. And that's how this works. Now, these numbers that we have as classes, they can be a range like this. You could also provide an array, so you could do something like this, and do 24, 30, and then 35. This should probably be separated with semicolon. let me try with commas to do a column, see what happens. Apparently it works like that too. So should work both ways, whether you do this or this. There it is. So those would be our classes from here. So now I have them hard coded. And finally, one last thing to remember about these classes is that even though we have them sorted here in this order, if you don't have them sorted internally, it's still going to sort those values. So if I did this like 30 and then 35 and then 24, I'm going to get the same results because internally it's going to sort these to go 24, 30, 35, and then it's going to do its thing. So if I hit enter, you'll see I get exactly the same results no matter how these are sorted. And that's all there is to it. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video.